Alright folks, today I'm showing you how to make this awesome looking cheeseburger roll. So stay tuned. It's time to grill. Let's get started with the dough for our cheeseburger roll. This is sour cream. You can also use double cream, I guess. You will need eggs. I used 3 eggs for a roll of that size. And grated cheese. Of course, I will put the exact measurements of each ingredient into the video description as always. So if you want to recreate this dish at home, make sure to check the video description. My first improvement after I recorded that video and made this recipe is add salt and pepper. Right now it's a little bit lame, and of course you have to check the consistency, it should not be too thin, so I decided to add some more of that cheese and 2 tablespoons of flour. Now it's looking good. Now take a baking tray or some baking grates and spread it over a baking sheet. You now see there are parts that are a little bit liquid, so make sure to have everything in the middle. To be 100% sure, just fold up the side of your baking sheet. In the meantime, I have already prepared my gas grill for indirect heat, 160 degrees Celsius, round about 320 degrees Fahrenheit. Of course, you can do this in the oven, same temperature, but I can show you how to make this one bake on a gas grill, for example. Here, just that piece, little helper, and then bake it for 30 minutes. In the meantime, we can prepare the stuffing for our cheeseburger roll. This is 400 grams of German's fresh ground beef. We season that with barbecue rub and just make it and let that one grill in your cast iron pan until it's brown enough and done. Of course, this is fresh ground beef. It should not be killed twice. After it has a nice and gently brown color, take it off, and here's the result of the baking process. Now I'm using a sharp knife to cut away the outer pieces so we have an equal and plain dough that can be stuffed and rolled easily. It can be removed from the baking sheet very quick. And it's easy enough. So that's it. And now feel free to use the stuffing for the cheeseburger you like. Of course, you can do a Big Mac cheeseburger roll or Big Mac roll using the Big Mac sauce. There are a lot of copycat recipes in the internet. You can do the Big King thing. You can do any burger you like. It's even fun to stuff that one with pulled pork, I guess. With more or mac and cheese, whatever. Feel free. Let your creativity help you to find the way you like it. I have to admit that I would rather have done a burger sauce thing than the barbecue sauce and of course some more sauce. I decided to spread over some diced pickles and some French onions as well. And again some more grated cheese inside that. I will tell you more about that in a minute. Now roll it up and then feel free to top the roll again with things you like. Of course, you can baste it with egg wash and add some sesame seeds. Or, like I did, just sprinkle over some more of that grated cheese and throw it back on the grill and let it bake again for 15 minutes. It's what I did. Of course, it should have grilled a little bit longer because the cheese inside that roll is not really melted. But, okay, maybe this is a complaint on high level. Here's the result. Fun to do. Spectacular. As a footage from a video creator perspective. I hope you like that. I would really appreciate you leave me a comment with the stuffing for your burger or your burger idea that you would prefer to cook inside that cheeseburger roll. Of course, I'm gonna give this a shot right now. Make sure to check out the ingredients and everything, my fan pages, hit that like button, subscribe. Thanks again. Anyway, I'm out. See you